Welcome to Amazing Weapons, where we explore the history and features of some of the most powerful and fascinating military machines in the world. Today, we are going to talk about the Merkava tank, Israel's main battle tank. But before we do that, let me ask you a question. Do you know why Israel decided to develop its own tank, and what challenges it faced? If you don't worry, because we are going to find out in this video. The Merkava tank is not just a weapon, but also a symbol of Israel's independence and survival. It was born out of the necessity to defend the country from its hostile neighbors, who had superior numbers and equipment. Israel had relied on foreign tanks, mainly from Britain and the US, but they were often outdated, unreliable, or unsuitable for the harsh terrain and climate of the Middle East. Moreover, Israel faced political and economic pressures that threatened to cut off its supply of tanks and spare parts. Therefore, in the late 1960s, Israel decided to design and produce its own tank based on its own operational needs and experience. The project was led by General Israel Tal, a veteran tank commander who had fought in several wars. He envisioned a tank that would provide maximum protection for its crew, superior mobility and firepower, and easy maintenance and repair. He also wanted a tank that could adapt to changing threats and technologies, and that could serve as a platform for other roles, such as infantry fighting or medical evacuation. The result was the Merkava tank, which means chariot in Hebrew. The first prototype was completed in 1974, and the first production model entered service in 1979. Since then, the Merkava has undergone several upgrades and modifications, resulting in four main variants: Mark 1, Mark 2, Mark 3, and Mark 4. Each variant has improved features and capabilities, such as more powerful engines, guns, armor, fire control systems, active protection systems, and electronic warfare systems. The Merkava tank has proven itself in combat in various conflicts and wars that Israel has been involved in, such as the 1982 Lebanon War, the 2006 Lebanon War, the Gaza War, and the 2023 Israel-Hamas War. The Merkava has faced different enemies and challenges, such as Syrian tanks, Hezbollah guerrillas, Hamas rockets, and Iranian drones. The Merkava has shown its effectiveness and survivability in these situations, as well as its versatility and flexibility for different missions. The Merkava tank is considered one of the best designed tanks ever produced and one of the most advanced tanks in service today. It is a unique and remarkable machine that reflects Israel's history and identity. It is not only a weapon of war, but also a tool of peace. The Merkava tank has a unique and distinctive design that sets it apart from most other tanks in the world. Unlike most tanks that have the engine in the rear and the turret in the center, the Merkava tank has the engine in the front and the turret in the rear. This layout has several benefits for the Merkava tank. It provides more protection for the crew, as the engine acts as an additional layer of armor against frontal attacks. The crew compartment is also surrounded by ammunition racks and fuel tanks that are isolated from the hull and can be jettisoned in case of fire. It creates more space in the rear of the tank that allows a rear door to be installed, which enables easy access and exit for the crew and passengers under enemy fire. The rear door can also be used to evacuate wounded soldiers or to transport infantry, supplies, or equipment. The Merkava tank can carry up to 10 soldiers or 3 stretchers inside. It improves the mobility and maneuverability of the tank, as the front heavy weight distribution reduces the risk of getting stuck in soft ground or sand. The Merkava tank also has a powerful engine and a sophisticated suspension system that allow it to traverse rough terrain and obstacles. The Merkava tank also has modular armor that can be easily removed and replaced in the field. The armor is composed of steel plates, ceramic tiles, composite materials, and reactive elements that can withstand different types of threats, such as kinetic energy penetrators, high-explosive anti-tank warheads, rocket-propelled grenades, and mines. The armor is also designed to absorb and deflect enemy fire, reducing spalling and shrapnel inside the tank. The Merkava tank has a 120mm smoothbore gun that can fire various types of ammunition, including high-explosive anti-tank, armor-piercing fin stabilized discarding sabot, high-explosive squash head, and laser-homing anti-tank guided missiles. The gun is stabilized and can be aimed independently from the movement of the tank. The Merkava tank also has several machine guns for anti-personnel and anti-aircraft purposes, as well as a 60mm mortar for firing smoke rounds or suppressing enemy positions. The Merkava tank has a sophisticated fire control system that includes a ballistics computer, a laser rangefinder, a thermal imager, a crosswind sensor, and a meteorological sensor. These systems enable the Merkava tank to acquire and engage targets accurately and rapidly in day or night conditions. The Merkava tank also has an active protection system called Trophy that can detect and intercept incoming missiles and rockets before they hit the tank. The Merkava tank is one of the most advanced tanks in service today. It combines high levels of protection, firepower, mobility, and versatility. It is designed to meet Israel's specific operational needs and terrain conditions. It is not only a weapon of war, but also a tool of peace. The Merkava tank has evolved through several generations since its first introduction in 1979. Each generation has improved features and capabilities based on Israel's operational needs and experience. Let's take a look at each model and see how they differ from each other. The Mark 1 was the original design that was based on the lessons learned from the 1973 Yom Kippur War. It had a 105mm main gun, a front engine, a rear turret, a rear door, and modular armor. It also had a 60mm mortar that was mounted externally and required manual operation. The Mark 1 weighed 63 tons and had a 908 horsepower diesel engine. It was first used in combat during the 1980 to Lebanon War, where it proved its superiority over Syrian tanks. The Mark II was introduced in 1983 and incorporated many adjustments and additions as a result of the Lebanon War. It had an Israeli-designed automatic transmission, increased fuel storage, anti-rocket netting, and updated meteorological sensors, crosswind analyzers, and thermographic optics. It also had a redesigned 60mm mortar that was located within the hull and configured for remote firing. The Mark II used the same 105mm main gun and weighed 65 tons. The Mark III was introduced in 1989 and was a major upgrade over the previous models. It had a larger 120mm smoothbore gun that could fire various types of ammunition, including laser homing anti-tank guided missiles. It also had a more powerful engine, a new fire control system, an electric turret, and an active protection system called Trophy that could detect and intercept incoming missiles and rockets. The Mark III also had modular composite armor that could be easily replaced or upgraded. The Mark III weighed 65 tons and had a top speed of 60 kilometers per hour. The Mark IV was introduced in 2004 and was the most advanced model of the Merkava series. It had a longer barrel for increased range and accuracy, a digital battle management system, a laser warning receiver, an electronic warfare system, and an air conditioning system. It also had improved optics and sensors that allowed day or night vision and hunter-killer capability. The Mark IV also had a remote-controlled 50 cal machine gun that could be aligned with the main gun and fired from inside the turret. The Mark IV weighed 65 tons and had a top speed of 64 kilometers per hour. The Mark V Barak entered service in 2023 and was the latest version of the Merkava series. It had an upgraded Trophy active protection system, 360-degree camera coverage for enhanced situational awareness, a helmet-mounted display for the tank commander, and new sensors that enabled autonomous target acquisition and engagement. It also had electronic warfare abilities, advanced processing systems, and a direct energy system capable of intercepting drones and cruise missiles. The Merkava tank has undergone significant changes over time to adapt to changing threats and requirements. It has become one of the most sophisticated tanks in service today, combining high levels of protection, firepower, mobility, and versatility. It is a unique and remarkable machine that reflects Israel's history and identity. Now, we are going to discuss how the Merkava tank performed in various conflicts and wars that Israel was involved in, such as the 1980 to Lebanon War, the 2006 Lebanon War, the Gaza War, and the 2023 Israel-Hamas War. We will also mention some of the challenges and limitations that the Merkava tank faced or may face in future scenarios. We will also address the question of why Israel has not exported the Merkava tank widely. Despite its outstanding qualities, the Merkava tank has been tested in combat since its first introduction in 1979. It has faced different enemies and threats, such as Syrian tanks, Hezbollah guerrillas, Hamas rockets, and Iranian drones. It has shown its effectiveness and survivability in these situations, as well as its versatility and flexibility for different missions. some of the notable achievements and incidents of the Merkava tank in combat. In the 1980 to Lebanon War, the Merkava Mark I outperformed the Syrian T-62 tanks and proved largely immune to the anti-tank weapons of the time. It was also used as a makeshift APC or armored ambulance by removing the ammunition racks and using the rear door. Israel lost dozens of tanks during the war, including several Merkavas. In the 2006 Lebanon War, five Merkava tanks were destroyed by Hezbollah's advanced anti-tank missiles, such as the RPG-29 and the Kornet. The Merkava Mark IV suffered two losses, one by a powerful IED and one by a Kornet missile. The Israeli military said that it was satisfied with the Merkava Mark IV's performance and attributed problems to insufficient training before the war. In total, 50 Merkava tanks were hit, 8 of which remained serviceable on the battlefield. In the Gaza War, the Merkava Mark IV was used more extensively and successfully. One brigade of Merkava Mark IV seconds managed to bisect the Gaza Strip in 5 hours without Israeli casualties. The tank also demonstrated its ability to launch smoke grenades and intercept incoming missiles and rockets with its trophy active protection system. No tanks were damaged during the war. In the 2023 Israel-Hamas war, two Merkava tanks were visually confirmed to be lost on the Gaza border on October 7th during the initial Hamas surprise attack into Israel. The tanks were hit by anti-tank missiles fired from tunnels or buildings. The IDF said that it was investigating the incident and that it would improve its tactics and technology to counter such threats. The Merkava tank is not without challenges and limitations, however. The tank is heavy and bulky, which makes it difficult to transport by air or sea. It also consumes a lot of fuel and requires frequent maintenance. The tank is designed for conventional warfare and may not be suitable for low-intensity conflicts or urban warfare, where it faces asymmetric threats such as eaves, mines, snipers, and ambushes. The tank relies on sophisticated systems and technologies that may malfunction or be jammed or hacked by enemy forces. It also depends on external support such as logistics, intelligence, air cover, and infantry cooperation. The tank is expensive to produce and operate, which limits its availability and affordability. It also faces competition from other tanks that may offer similar or better capabilities at lower costs. One question that may arise is why Israel has not exported the Merkava tank widely, despite its outstanding qualities. There are several reasons for this. Israel considers the Merkava tank as a strategic asset that reflects its national security and identity. It does not want to share its secrets or lose its edge over potential adversaries. Israel faces political and diplomatic constraints that limit its export markets. It cannot sell the tank to countries that are hostile to it or that may violate human rights or international law. Israel faces technical and logistical challenges that hinder its export potential. It cannot guarantee spare parts or maintenance for foreign customers who may have different standards or requirements. Israel faces economic and competitive challenges that reduce its export attractiveness. It cannot offer attractive prices or incentives for foreign customers who may prefer cheaper or more advanced alternatives. Therefore, Israel has only exported some components or variants of the Merkava tank to a few countries, such as Colombia, Philippines, Singapore, Australia, Canada, and India. The Merkava tank is not just a weapon, but also a symbol of Israel's independence and survival. It reflects Israel's history and identity, as well as its technological and military achievements. It combines high levels of protection, firepower, mobility, and versatility, and incorporates advanced systems and technologies that make it a formidable opponent on the battlefield. It is also designed to be cost-effective, easy to maintain, and suitable for different roles and missions. The Merkava tank is a unique and remarkable machine that deserves our respect and admiration. It is a product of Israel's ingenuity, creativity, and determination. It is a testament to Israel's ability to overcome challenges and achieve excellence. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed learning about the Merkava tank. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more amazing weapons videos. Also, don't forget to leave a comment below and let us know what you think about the Merkava tank. Do you like it? Do you think it is the best tank in the world? What other tanks would you like us to cover in our future videos? We would love to hear from you.